welcome, and thank you for coming today. Today, we're going to do some teachings on tobacco and social protocol, and I hope that you have a little bit of fun in the meantime. My name is Maggie. I'm with UABS. I sit on the Elders Council Health Domain, and I am part of the leadership circle for UABS. To my left here is Alma Garb. Alma.
Hello, welcome. I'm part of the leadership circle as well, and part of the justice domain.
All right. Thank you, Alma. And this is Gaylene Juno.
I'm Gaylene, and I'm along with the leaders domain, and I am one of the speakers for the women's circle.
Thank you. Today, when we start when we think of tobacco. Tobacco sometimes can get very confusing to a lot of people who've never done this before. So we're going to put examples in a lot of places. But first, we're going to speak of Mother Earth. Mother Earth and the tree standing people and the plant people, because that's where we get all of our tobacco at different times of the year. When we are going out, we will have all kinds of wonderful prayers and good thoughts to take the plants or to take the tobaccos in a good way with our hearts and with our mind. We also have in our understanding that when we speak of Mother Earth, we speak of Mother Earth as being somebody who nurtures us, somebody who feeds us, somebody who cares for us. And in our respect, when we go to get tobaccos, when we go to pick any type of medicine for any reason, we always give an offering back. And this is going to be, the first part is going to be about tobaccos. The second part will be about social protocol. Because a lot of us have questions of, what do I do? How do I get started? What do I do with all this idea that I want to start a cultural journey? And most of that starts with asking an elder. Asking an elder a question and asking an elder to teach you. Now, that will be the second part. And that is going to be all about different types of that's an organic tobacco. That's a tobacco that somebody's grown in their field. Now, some people actually grow their own tobacco. And some people, well, if we live in the cities, you can't always get out there. And if you're a little bit like me and you're a little bit crippled up, you're definitely probably not getting out there. So, we don't use that sometimes. We will use tobacco that is brought from different companies, right? smells like black licorice. Very strong when you first go out to the bush to pick it. And people will pick off small parts of it or grind it down. Sometimes they put it with three other tobaccos. They'll use regular tobacco, they'll use diamond willow, and they'll use buffalo sage and sweetgrass. That's going to be our last one here. Sweetgrass also is considered one of our tobaccos. Now some people also use brown cedar. I don't happen to have found any, but the cedar is quite common for some people. All of these can be chopped and picked at different times. In our school system, we've had gardens where they grow sweetgrass, where they grow some of our tobaccos. And they are now starting to teach the children about our tobaccos. So that we find as a positive thing in our hearts. During this time of COVID though, that may be something that we will have to work on in a different way. But we will work on it. So those are the types of tobacco that are commonly used for the Great Plains people. Now this won't apply if you're a West Coaster from the West Coast. You will not use any of these tobaccos. Right? And they will not smudge in that way. They will have their own, and you will need to speak to them about it. But for today, we were speaking of the Great Plains people and their tobaccos. So, our next one is about tobacco ties. Now, I have two specific ties here. Know what they're for? Offering. That's right. Why is one red and why is one white? Does anybody know? No? Okay. Red is for your physical state of being. White is for your spiritual state of being, for your ancestors and your spirit. There are some tobacco ties that are done in different colors according to their Sundance leaders or according to their tribal customs. And we always say, go to your elder and ask. Now, how do we go to the elder to ask? We offer them a little bit of tobacco. Now, let's say for some reason or another, you don't have all this tobacco or whatever. Here's a cigarette. So, as let's say you're on the spot, you see an elder, and you want to ask a question. This is what they do. And before an elder accepts it, right, they will ask you, what are you asking me? Because if I cannot answer it, I will not accept that tobacco, right? So sometimes an elder will not accept the tobacco if they do not know what you are asking. Then they'll refer you to somebody else, or if they feel you are not ready. And it is not something to punish you. It is something from their heart. They will look at that and say, this is your time, or this is when we can do it, or yes, we will start this. So elders have a whole pile of their own rules. And if you ever think that you're doing it wrong, believe me, every elder will tell you when you got it wrong, right? They have no problem at being able to tell you you are not in the right path, and they will correct you. So don't ever worry about, oh, I'm going to get it all wrong. We don't have to worry about getting it wrong, because they'll tell you when you good print that we call grandmother's print, right? And it's usually flowers, soft pastel colors, very small flowers, not really big like sunflower print, but usually some small flowers and prints like that. So you can see it? Yeah. Okay. Then, as we're putting this in, you're thinking of your question. And you're having a good prayer and a good thought about what you need to ask and why you do it. So you're making a demacticide now. That is how big. Show everybody and let's
I'd
see.
I'd say it's a 4x4 square.
4 inch by 4 inch square. Now, they can be as small as you say, 2 inch by 2 inch. And that would be for a different reason. So, acceptability of being that big, or smaller yet. Now, let's say we're going to go also, while she's making this, and thinking of her question, and praying in her heart about what she needs to ask when she makes her tobacco tie, we're going to talk about, let's say we want to go to a group of elders, and sometimes that's like really nerve-wracking. It's like, oh my God, I got to talk in front of a whole group of elders, or I want to ask them a question. What do I do? So then you get a basket, and you make more than enough for the elders that show up in that circle. And before they even allow you to sit outside and ask your question, they'll call you over and you will give each one a tobacco tie and tell them generally what you're asking of the elders. And you will pass that all the way around the circle. Then you will sit and you will listen, and they will tell you how they're going to address your question or what you need to say. Maybe you're presenting something to them, a project or whatever. That is proper protocol for presenting to an elder. These protocols are shown for a cultural respect of people who have knowledge within culture, knowledge within the land, knowledge within what we call natural or earth knowledge, right? And we rely on them as a culture of people to give us a sense of guidance. And a lot of times, they will answer your question only in parts. And it will feel very frustrating. But that's part of learning patience. That's part of understanding that just like this tree and the tree standing people, they've been here for a while. And all you have to do is sit underneath this tree to enjoy it. Now, she's made her tobacco offering. Her tobacco tie. A prayer tobacco is different. That's done in ceremony. Today we will not address that. That is not something I'm comfortable with to put on a recording. So, in passing the tie, you put it in my hand, and now you give me your question that you thought about